Hello. So I found myself at the driving range on this October afternoon to practice my swing and also give you some science. All right. Here's the deal. I want you to figure out what kind of forces are involved when I swing and hit the ball, and then the ball flies through the air and then eventually drops. So what forces are acting upon this ball? Now, what I can tell you about the types of clubs is they are numbered, and then there's a pitching wedge and a driver. The lower the number, the longer distance it can travel, because the angle of the club is at a lesser degree. So if you go ahead and research golf clubs distances, you will see it says 9 iron, 45 degree loft. So that's how high it can go up in the air. So if you don't want to go that long of a distance, you'd probably use a 9 iron rather than a 4 or 3 iron, which is approximately 195 yards it could travel with a 10 degree loft. So I'm pretty sure I'm correct on that, but we can go and Google it again and check in on the range of distances with the different clubs. But right now I have a 7 iron, so it's not going about 100 yards if I'm lucky. But again, what I want us to focus on is what forces are being acted upon this ball when I swing, and then what is continuing to act on this golf ball in order for it to continue flying in the air and then eventually landing in a spot. All right, ready? Here we go. Bend my knees, like my dad told me. Keep my fingers loose. Keep my eye on the ball. Don't lift my eyes. And follow through with your hips. And then look like you're really an expert and cool doing this. It went up there, but only about 85 yards. Okay, figure it out, do some more research, and let me know. Forces, energy, motion, science.